drive, different people, everyone's walking around here. There are these contraptions, there are these transportation networks, if you want to call them, or the roller coasters that. But they're going everywhere, and they're doing crazy things to people, 4 or 5 G, just insane stuff. They're insured, and they have a much higher safety record than our roads. Much higher. 5 out of a million instead of get injured, and instead of 106 out of a million dying on our roadways. So what if we took a step back and looked at our cities and tried to turn them into amusement parks? What, you know, we got all this congestion on our roads. You know, there's this gentleman right here, Mike Stanley from Transit X, and everyone go outside and check out his booth. But we could have solar powered pod cars everywhere. And this can all be privately funded and privately operated without any subsidies. And we can insure these just like we insure amusement rides. The ASTM, the F-24, the same insurance industries. They're right there to tap into.
Are these elevated?
Yeah, they're elevated. They're above or they're below ground, but they're elevated and they're small and they don't have a big visual impact compared to what we're used to, compared to these big freeway overpasses and the power lines. They can be solar powered because, again, you don't move a whole car, you move just what you need, which is the cabin of the car.
Is it 1 or 2 people?
It can be up, they're all different. It can be up to 5 people, it can be, you know, they're different systems. I mean, there are many different technologies. And Judith, who's a big advocate here, there's a law. It's called the Solar Mobility Act. Okay, it's actually sitting, and there's, I don't want to get into the details, but it's sitting in the legislature here in this state. Why don't they just pass it?
I mean, well, what's the basis of it?
The basis of it, okay. It's a very simple law, 7 points. Basically, if you are a transportation company with a new innovation like Transit X, and you can, and you're 5 times more efficient than a car, and you can be privately funded, privately operated without any subsidies, then you should be able to build this stuff above our city streets or on the side of the highway, make that space available for lease. Everyone, when you're sitting in traffic, look up and say, wow, what if the city just leased that space to innovators? And we didn't have to pay a dime. What if these innovators paid us 5% to actually solve this problem, to deliver solar-powered transportation networks? The technology is there, but we're stuck in the past. We're stuck using old technology, old ways subsidizing it, and we've been ruining our health. There are solutions.
And that, come on up, if you go ahead and ask a question, that gets to be a little bit of the complication, right, in the leasing of those air rights, because it seems to me we had somebody on that was doing this in a different country, and they were having problems acquiring those rights. But come on up and make a statement or have a quick question.
So this might be related. My frame of reference is Route 128 between Waltham.